Hi, I'm Vince, and I'm with Arc'teryx. So the new Sequence harness, which comes out spring 20, is an evolution of the Arc'teryx Warp Strength technology. So our previous harnesses did a lot of things that were really awesome, but we wanted to improve on it. And one of the things that's really important for climbers is mobility. One of the things we knew about our harness was that it offered lots of comfort and mobility, but we could do better. So we teamed up with a biomechanical engineer and a designer to really work through what we could adapt from Warp Strength to improve on our harness fits. So if you compare this harness to our previous harness, you'll find that it's much narrower in terms of the width. And there's actually a lot of engineering that's gone into the sculpting of not only the SWAMI, but also of the leg loops to make it more comfortable. The team spent a lot of time having people sit in the harness, and I was one of the sitters, to make sure that this thing was actually going to be as comfortable as possible. So they spent many hours kind of prototyping the shape, the contour, and the materials to get to this point. The other thing that's really nice about the harness, so we've got an adaptation and an evolution of our gear loops. So our other gear loops were plastic, and they really did help the gear range forward. With these new gear loops, you can see they still have flexibility, and it's a very small engineered web cord on the inside. We're using the same cord as a hull loop, and it makes for a very clean package that's very easy to use. One of the other benefits we've done with this new construction, we've actually added some air mesh on the back of the harness. So once again, trying to look for more comfort for the climber. And these are all also still made in Canada. We definitely knew that in the beginning with Warp, it offered a thin harness, which was really what we were after. And to get the comfort, the width was really what we thought necessary. At that time, the technology and our knowledge didn't allow us to play with Warp as much as we can now. So the learnings we've had in probably the 7 or 8 years since the first Warp came out has allowed us to actually sculpt it a lot more so we can reduce the width and do different laminations to come up with that comfort and thinness in one package. So it's really been about evolving. And if you saw the amount of prototypes at the office, you'd be surprised by how many iterations they've had to do to kind of get to this point. What we're looking to do is basically, because anatomy is so different between a man and a woman, we really want to make sure that each customer had the best possible fit. So Katie and Cam did a lot of work, not only measuring men, but actually spent way more time in the beginning measuring women and trying to understand all the different variations, especially between waist, hip, and rise, and how to optimize the new sequence patterns so it would fit her as good as possible, if not the best possible. The Arc'teryx Sequence harness is available for both men and women in spring 20. One is what we're looking for, US. And it comes in a very nice new stuff sack that's good for many things, and it's all made out of repurposed material from previous projects. We'll be phasing out some of the models we currently have, but basically the plan is to move out of the current harnesses and to go onto this, and then bring in new stuff down the road. So there's more stuff in the pipe that we're cooking up. Honestly, the team spent so much time measuring people and trying to figure out, like, we knew the base loss. Like, we had our kind of Arc'teryx recipe to make Warp Strength. We knew we needed to adapt it, and we knew what we wanted to achieve out of it, but what actually measured success and how you quantified it was what the team spent a lot of time trying to figure out. It was like, you know, when we do this, how do we tell we succeeded? And it was really trying to solve that problem for the user of how do we make it better, more comfortable, and allow for more freedom of movement. And that was the hard part, going through all the fittings, getting people into the bouldering gym so they could hang there uncomfortably and stuff, really being open about how you felt, and really making sure that we listened to everyone and all the testers who, like, there's probably 60 people who went through this program to try to figure out what worked and what didn't. So the real crux was just really finding what was wrong with our current ones and how to improve those things, or if things were good, how to make them better. So building it was one thing, but actually understanding what to build, once again, was the problem to solve.